Hello, today for review I've got one of the most recent products released by FiiO. It is their most affordable Bluetooth receiver. They give him name µBTR. Mu, it's Greek letter, probably in this case it means micro because it's their most affordable model. They really understand that future of the market is in wireless. And they decided to release a really affordable model. Price of this receiver is $26 approximately. It depends on taxes, laws, customs and so on. But it offers pretty good sound, nice design and so on. It uses good codec from Qualcomm and TPA as operational amplifier. It's not the most powerful device, definitely. It gives 10 milliwatts for 32 ohms load, but actually it's more than enough for vast majority of IEMs, and it created for to use with IEMs, and it can be easily used with multi-driver IEMs because its output impedance is 0.3 ohms. So let's have a closer look. Outer box is absolutely simple. It's made of white cardboard with device pictured on it, and actually it's embossed a little bit, so it's you can sense it by touch. Pretty nicely done. On the back side, we can read that its weight is 12.5 grams. Really small size, so actually not much details listed here. So let's open this box. Let me remove it. As usual, there is scratch sticker, so you can scratch it and check if this one is the original version. So here it is, device itself. It's secured with rubber band. I don't know why for. So here, device itself. And in bottom part, how to open it, we've got small USB-C cable, warranty card and manual. So just a basic accessory set. Design is fairly simple and probably it inspired by some early Apple designs. Device made of plastic, but of course for this price range it's okay and it's expectable. But it is really high quality plastic. Front panel is covered with curved glass and I'd say it looks pretty stylish. It's small, it's lightweight, so you can clip it everywhere and it won't burden you much. There are two buttons for volume control, on off button, microphone separate, headphone output and the USB-C for charging. I'm glad that FiiO started moving towards USB-C, and as you can see here is indicator LED. Now changing color because I've turned this on in pairing mode. So let's try to pair it. Bluetooth, let me turn it on. It has NFC for quick pairing, so if some devices support USB-C, it will be beneficial for you. But so about battery lifetime, meanwhile it's about 9 hours, stated 9 hours, but I usually got about 8 hours, and to charge it fully it takes about 1 hour. So as you can see, it's connected. Qualcomm aptx codec is used, and when it connected to the iPhone it uses AAC codec and it shows it its battery status in iOS widget and in status bar. It's a really good feature that I am often missed with some other Bluetooth receivers. And the Bluetooth range, actually it's pretty close to the stated 10 meters or 30 feet. Not thick walls between the source and receiver won't be an issue. But of course it depends on the quality of your player or your smartphone's Bluetooth. Sonically, well, it's probably not some high-end device, but it sounds pretty nicely. no issues with, you know, with treble. Of course, it will be simplified because APTX is a lossy codec. Treble will be simplified, but actually it will sound not super distorted. Mids are clean and clear, and bass is pretty punchy and well controlled. Of course, it's not the model for some hard to drive, power hungry headphones. It tailored for the IEMs, and luckily it drive almost every IEM that I have, even pretty tough models. And what I like the most, it's that it is almost dead silent, almost zero background noise, just a slight hint of noise with Campfire Audio Andromedas, but with all other IEMs, even pretty sensitive, it has zero noise. Of course, you can hear the difference between wired connection and wireless. And APTX codec isn't perfect, but it's still pretty nice, and it's enough to enjoy music in almost any circumstances, especially when you are on the street, for example. So I can definitely say that this is a device for those who'd like to listen music wirelessly, for those who have some modern smartphone without headphone output, or who wants to, you know, stream music from your computer and while you move around your house. So it's a pretty good device in almost any circumstances. It will be a nice gift for some friend, for example, and so on and so forth. So it combines stylish look, pretty long work time, normal sound, good design. So I think it will be really successful device. And but I'm actually waiting for the FiiO's BTR3, because, you know, it's hard to be an audiophile. You always want some best device. But so let's wait and see what they will offer. Thank you for attention.